community gardening. They call it urban permaculture, and I was very happy. I see Willie here. We were very happy to see the urban garden in on the Coop is what?
Kutikwat
Hospital. Thank you for, you know, in scarcity people steal. In abundance people share. Look at this. This is Liwa Street in Taiwan. This is a real picture. That's my daughter there. See, we went there, went all the way. It's all there. And the other one is what I call road sharing. What is road sharing? First, bias for public transportation. Your minister mentor, your first prime minister, knew that. He was a man of great mission. Bias for public transportation and not a bias for motor vehicles, for cars. So that's why you have one of the better public transportation systems. And provide space for people to walk and people for non-motorized vehicles. Why is it going to change? Oh, this one, I invented this. I am a part-time inventor. I am a crazy genius. This is a solar-powered, wind-powered, and pedal-powered, all charging a bank of batteries, and it moves. So, Madam Shell, President, you should be thinking about that. And then, how do I explain CPR economics? I have booked in a very simple theory. And what is CPR? Conservation, protection, and restoration. Look at this. So in my book, I show examples of how it is happening around the world. 20 examples, 3 of which are in the Philippines. This is a spectacular example, the Chonggi River. In Seoul, they cemented the top of the river. Who's been to Seoul? They cemented the top of the river, but then one enlightened mayor comes in, and breaks it up, and then turns it into a river. It is now main attraction. You don't need money to go to a mall. In the Philippines, our park has become the mall. The mall has become our park, only open spaces. This is another example, Iloilo River. It used to be dirty. They restored it in a matter of 3 years, and it now has this called Esplanade, which is more beautiful than the Esplanade of Paris. And this is another example of Sagay Marine Reserve. It used to be the hotbed of dynamite fishing, of illegal fishing. Now it has been converted into a working, the best example of marine reserve where people are no longer poor. The poverty rate is practically zero. All because they took care of the law of life. Oh, on page 157 of my book, I said, why do we fill up? You see, you have living soil, you pave it over with concrete, and then you just use it as parking. I said, why can, especially in a space challenged place like the Philippines, I said, why can we not turn the parking lots into parks? I was dreaming. And then the governor of one of the provinces, who's my friend, is going to convert the parking lot, it has a budget already, the parking lot into a park. It's going to happen next year. So these practical pathways, we are in immensity, monstrous challenges of hunger, extreme poverty, poisoning, flooding, social alienation, nature deficit disorder, criminality, and the crime crisis. We are not going to solve the problems. These practical pathways will dissolve the problem. Traffic. Oh, my friends, these are, who are the most powerful leaders? These people? Who are they? Oh, there's a good-looking gentleman there. They are not the most powerful leaders in the world who play with phallic symbols of power. The most powerful leaders in the world are two women. They are Miss Hope and Miss Inspiration. Hope springs eternal. And inspiration is the rocket fuel for the fire of desire. Desire makes the world go round. You desire, you want to make a change, you want to do this, you want to do that. That is what drives us. Oh, but you will ask, the men will say, why are they all women? Because, my friends, I am a great believer. It is symbolic of my belief that if you want anything said, give it to a man. Like to me, like Tamiko, you give it to a man. But if you want anything done, and done well, give it to a woman. My friends, And this is a book that I just finished when I was here in November. Yeah, this is a book that I just finished. It was supposed to be launched today, but it is arriving this afternoon. The plans are made by mice and men, and I will show you instead a film that was done. Yes. I will bring you to the gardens of goodness, to the fields of my follies, my frustrations, and my failures. And most of all, we will walk together to the mountaintops of magical moments. These are the stories from around the world, I told you. And, you know, when I suffer a setback, this is the place I had, the School of the Sea. I ran it without any funding whatsoever, but then Typhoon Haiyan came. And he did not damage us, directly hit us, he did not damage us, he wiped us out, he erased us. And I have since tried to recover, and on April 20 to 22, I am going to rebuild it. I bought a ticket to the lotto, I'm going to win this afternoon. I never bother with money, so I'm going to rebuild from the School of the Sea, it's going to become the Sea Camp. SICAM stands for Sea and Earth Advocates of Culture, Arts, and Music for the Planet. You are all invited. Lin Heng is going to be your tour coordinator. She is coming. Nelson has been there. Oh, this is the beachfront. We have a beautiful beachfront. It's the only beachfront in the Philippines that is not occupied by people, neither by the resort These are the hammocks. I call them the debt-free hammocks. Why debt-free? Because when you lie down there, you forget all your debts. So one is owned by Lin Heng, the other one is owned by Nick Robinson, so you can borrow it from there. So we will have a festival, a three-day festival of the arts. And I will explain to you why the arts. It's called, formerly, the School of the Sea. This is the site development plan. It's a big piece of property. It's a very, very valuable piece of property. I inherited this part here from my grandfather, and then I got all of this so I could make a beautiful place. And then this is, Earth. To protect the Earth, we must use the heart. Because science and law, which we've been doing, science and law speaks to the mind, gives us the direction, but art gives the inspiration for action. We have been trying to change the mind. I mean no offense, I'm a lawyer. We've been trying to change the mind. The scientists have been trying to change the mind. But people are not driven by the mind, they're driven by the heart. We are, and so I put up this, art is the language of the soul as music is the language of the heart. And how do we do that? Contained in the word earth and heart is a common word called art. So I put this up, small building, long time ago. It was the only small building that was not touched by Hayan. I called it the climate change house. It's now going to be expanded with my winnings in the lotto this afternoon. And then there is, at the back, there is a big piece of property. It's a wetland. And instead of developing it into subdivision and keeping it as a wetland, and then excavating it, dredging it as a wetland, into bird sanctuary. Look at this, Chinese egrets. These are just some birds that are there now. This is documented. Almost 100 species, out of 500 species of birds in the world, there are about 100 species there. Just in that little patch. And then we're going to build this. It's an eco-conference center, only for health, environment, and other social and civic causes. You cannot meet for politics, you cannot meet there, you cannot use it to make money. So we're going to build it, and again, I issue this invitation. So, in summary, three things. One is, how are we going to paint the future? I will not be here 30 years from now. But you, the students, the incoming students will be here. How are you going to paint the future? Will you paint the same? Will you paint the future using the old paint brushes that we used to paint the past? And we saw that it doesn't work. We need 9 earths. My friends, you think Tami Ko is good? Yes, he's good. You think Lin Heng is good? You think Ko Kin Yen is good? You think Sekar and Edwin are good? No. You have to be. You think I'm good? No. You have to be better. We are better. Yes, we're trying to do our best. But you, my dear young people, you have to be better than us 10 times over. Why? Because your problems, your challenges are 10 times worse. So you have to be better than us. You have to start. I always tell my students, don't follow my footsteps. Start from where I leave off. Number two is lessons learned. It's all play. And in triumph and disaster, the only prescription is laughter and the practical pathways. My friends, the most important chapter in this book, I'm looking for it. The most, I shipped it here, and then there was a holiday yesterday, so we could not bring it out. And it has to go through so much bureaucracy. Anyway, the last, the most important chapter of this book is this. Painting our future. And you know what it's going to look like? It's black. Because I say, for the last hour or so, while you've been reading it, I have taken you for a walk. Now it is your turn to tell us your story of what you want the world to be. Whatever it is you can do or dream you can, begin it. In boldness, there is genius, power, and magic. And the last line is, there is no limit to what we can achieve when we unleash the native genius of the human heart. is the most important chapter. My friends, in closing, I wrote this line, says, if you want to be heard, tell a story. If you want to touch the heart, sing a song. If you want to start a revolution, even a peaceful revolution of the mind and of the heart, ask a question. The question that we think we should ask ourselves is, do you, young people, and your children, do you deserve the earth that we're leaving behind? If not, what is it that we need to do? You don't need more theses. You don't need more dissertations. You need action. Awareness without action is nothing more than a bow without an arrow, useless each without the other. My friends, from my inmost heart of hearts, I thank my dear friend, Lin Heng, who is the ever-ready buddy. She is a bundle of energy. And Shirley and Ayu, is Ayu here? Are you supposed to call her because she will sing now? Please. And then the MEM program. I was telling your director, Zekar, but you know, this is the most unusual, and you're very lucky to be here. Because it is the most unusual, you know, you have a breadth, you have nine colleges, nine universities. Yes, my friends, humans are most active when they're standing up. They're most creative when they're lying down. The compromise is to sit down. But we have compromised too much. In the same manner that you've been sitting down the whole morning. Sitting is the new smoking, it's bad for your health. So as a symbol of action, please stand up. And please recite these lines with me. Do not recite this to me. Do not recite it to the director, to Lin Heng, to Kang Yin, to Edwin. Recite it to this little boy. Because this little boy is going to be here 30 years from now, 50 years from now. And he and his generation will hold us to account for what we do or for what we fail to do today. Begin. 10, 50, 100 years from now, many generations still have. Wait, I don't hear those people at the back. You don't get that. Louder, please. Speak from the heart. Again. 10, 50, 100 years from now, and many generations still have. Let it be said that during our watch, while gifted with intelligence and insight, with privilege and position, with the wealth of wisdom, and with the freedom and power of the human will, let it be said that in our time and during our watch, we did our best. And maybe, just maybe, we will make a little difference. Again, my young friends, you have to be 10 times better than all of us combined. You see, it is easy to make money, but it is more meaningful to make a little difference. I have no doubt that you will not only make a little difference, you will make the difference in your generation. Congratulations for your admission, and I wish you the best of luck in the next year. My friends, a special number. You may sit down, you may stand up, you may dance. But a special number, before you all sing, you don't know it yet, but you will all sing. There will be a special number by, you know, MEM is a very multi-talented. It is multifaceted, multidisciplinary, it is also multi-talented. So, Mr. give a big round of applause to John Denver of Singapore. Just say no.